except for today, has been removed. There will be no discussion item or action item on behalf of the council on HB2 tonight. We have been talking, I've been talking with council members throughout the day, and collectively, we have concluded that discussion of HB2 for the city council tonight would not be helpful in advancing a solution to the ongoing challenges of HB2. Staff will.
Thank you so much, Mayor and honorable council members. My name is Chad Griffin. I'm the president of the Human Rights Campaign. Tonight, I'm here on behalf of HRC's thousands of members all across the city and tens of thousands of members all across this state. And I'm here on behalf of them to say thank you. Thank you for standing up for what's right when you join more than 100 other American cities and pass the non-discrimination ordinance here in Charlotte. And thank you for continuing to stand up and stand your ground today by defending the equal rights and equal dignity of all LGBT people. We all know there are a few in this state that day in and day out try to point blame, assign blame, and point fingers as to who created the problem and the nightmare that is HB2. There is only one entity to blame, and there is only one governor who signed HB2. And there is only one solution to the nightmare that he created, and that is a full and complete repeal of HB2. When folks bring up and talk about a deal, what kind of deal? One must first ask, so who are you willing to leave on the table? That's the first question. Who are you going to leave behind amongst those that you attacked in HB2? Who will you leave on the cutting room floor? And it takes all of us in this room, and all of you to stand up and to stand strong and to say there is only one solution, and that is a complete repeal of HB2. And I'll just leave you with this. If we're in this room tonight, if you're seated there in front of me or all of us who are seated in this hall this evening, we're the really lucky ones, the damn lucky ones. And all of you and all of us are here in this room for those young people who can't be in this room, those young transgender people all across the state that were attacked by HB2. Attacked. So when you go to bed tonight, and you'll get in your room, turn out the lights, get in bed, and go to sleep, remember there are countless people all across the state who today will do that same thing, but when they get in bed, they'll stare at the ceiling all night, fearing the potential doom of the next day. You are standing strong for those young people. And for that leadership, we say thank you.
Ma'am, in Jesus' name, would you stop and let me have 3 minutes, please?
I'm going to have to ask security to ask you to leave.
Ma'am, I am asking you to let me speak. That's all I want is just 3 minutes, because it is not a sin to be black. It is not a sin to be born a man. It's not a sin to be born a woman. But it is a sin, according to the Bible, to be a practicing homosexual. And these things we must deal with. These things are, you have turned on the loose. It has started here. Don't blame the people in lobby.
Disrupting our meeting.
It's all about you.
Ma'am,
in Jesus' name, I'm asking you to repent of what you have done to our city.
Hear me speak.
The confusion that you
have brought to our city. I'm going to have to ask our officer to have to leave the chamber.
The confusion that you have brought to our city and to our nation. Ma'am, in Jesus' name, I asked you to speak. I signed up to speak.
Mayor, I should have stepped down.
Yes, sir.
Regular meeting rules, and those require 10 speakers when they're speaking on items that are not on the agenda.